They were the leading icons of their time. Ward was a gifted architect, Moyer a leading carriage and auto manufacturer. This is the story of them and their family. Originally from Massachusetts and growing up in a log cabin, Jacob Moyer, of Holland Dutch descent, left the Mohawk Valley and traveled by ox cart with his family and settled in Baldwinsville, New York. This is Jacob Moyer's home on Grego Road. Jacob Moyer's son, Oliver Moyer, and his wife, Maria E. Abbott Moyer, have their one and only child, February 7th, 1855, in Clay, New York. They named their son Harvey Allen Moyer. Oliver Moyer has a large farm between Clay and Baldwinsville, today believed to be the site of Moyer's Corners. This garment here was worn by young H.A. Moyer as an infant. This garment as H.A. Moyer was a toddler. Notice the detail of the paperweight buttons. H.A. Moyer quit school after his third grade graduation. It's part his decision, part Oliver Moyer, his father's decision for him to work on the farm. H.A. Moyer has other ideas, the urge to build. This is an example. This cart. The Civil War is over now. It's 1867. H.A. Moyer is 12. He builds his first shop. H.A. installs a stove in the shop. His parents tell him to move the shop because they don't want him to burn down the house or barn. So H.A. Moyer moves it out into the middle of the orchard. Once there, he builds his first wagon with supplies he buys in Baldwinsville. From Mr. William Lust. In July 1871, H.A. Moyer, 16, marries Rosamond Wilcox, 17, in Baldwinsville. Rosamond Wilcox is the daughter of Cheney and Roxy Fancher Wilcox. At 16, H.A. Moyer left the farm to sell wooden pumps, first in retail in Bridgeport, New York, then in wholesale quantities for the Toledo Pump Company. For 4 years, H.A. Moyer is on the road. His territory covers Ohio and Pennsylvania, while his new bride, Rosamond Moyer, stays in Baldwinsville with her parents and new in-laws. On March 19, 1874, H.A. Moyer and Rosamond Wilcox Moyer have a son, who they name Bertram Wilcox Moyer, born in Cicero, New York, where the Moyers have recently moved to. Cicero, 1876. H.A. Moyer is 21. With $20 of capital, hangs his own sign over his own first carriage shop and factory. He repairs wagons, but also that year builds 28 new wagons. His new wagon bore his name, the Moyer. November 3rd, 1877. The Moyers have a daughter who they name Bertha Maud Moyer. The young child suffers from allergies and asthma. Even then, the Moyer wagon was considered superior in design and detail. From 1877 through 1880, with 30 employees, 1,000 carriages and wagons are built each year in Cicero. 1880, H.A. Moyer buys this house in Syracuse, New York, on the corner of First North and Bear Streets. Shortly thereafter, H.A. Moyer's grandmother, Margaret Moyer, dies May 2, 1880, at the age of 73. On January 13, 1881, Moyer purchases property for his new carriage factory in Syracuse, New York, bordering Park, Wolf, Hiawatha, and Salina Streets. In 1882, Moyer erected a large building on the corner of Wolf and Park Streets. Its front on Wolf Street housed its showroom and offices. Its roof had a little rotunda with a carriage on top of it. This is the old toll booth on Old Liverpool Road. Here, Moyer passed through it and onto his new property. It's 1883. H.A. Moyer purchases 157 acres of land in Liverpool, New York, bordering Old Liverpool Road and Old Buckley Road a mile in each direction. An existing cobblestone house on the Buckley roadside starts off the Moyer stock farm. An English-style barn is built and matching barn, plus houses are constructed on the Old Liverpool roadside of the property. The 157-acre estate will be called Moyerdale. In 1883 and 1884, another large building expanding H.A. Moyer's carriage factory is built on Salina and Hiawatha Streets. This is the building with the famous Victorian house on the top of the roof. The lady who H.A. Moyer buys the property from stipulates in her deed a copy of her Victorian house must always be seen on the property for all time. Even to this day, gossip about the Victorian house on the top of the building has gone on for years. Its actual function was to house the top of the elevator shaft. These steam-powered elevators ran at 20 horsepower and fitted with a complete line of such machinery as is required in such a business, much of which is a novel and ingenious construction.